time to proclaim the year of the Lord. Prepare the way.
Unite our heart in prayer and let us declare the seven light of our God, the Spirit of God, as Pastor light the candle of the menorah. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. And as a prophetic gesture, let us continue to be in the spirit of worship and intercession. Abba, Father God, as we light, O God, the seven candles of the menorah, representing your seven spirit, O God. And so we decree, Abba Yahweh, your spirit, O God, your Shekinah glory, the Ruach HaKodes, to fill this nation, O God. We pray, O God, for the spirit of knowledge, for the spirit of wisdom, spirit of understanding, for the spirit of might, for the spirit of counsel, for the spirit of the reverential fear of the Lord, and for the spirit of truth, O God. We decree and declare it will now fill our nation, O God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, we pray, and everybody say amen. So I would like to present to you the video, current event, kung anong ginagawa ngayon ng Diyos sa bansa. So this is a proof of God's protection over Israel. Na nagpadala po siya ng napaka-kapal na storm dust. Ito po ay pumagit na doon po sa boundary ng Syria to protect Israel. At yung po ay angel na kung saan po ay talagang with kanya po tinarget yung missile. Yan po. Na galing sa Gaza na
aim their rockets more effectively. We do aim them, but their God changes their path in midair. At this point, we had just 4 seconds until the missile lands. We had already notified emergency services to converge on the target location and had warned of a mass casualty incident. Suddenly, Iron Dome, which calculates wind speeds among other things, shows a major wind coming from the east, a strong wind.
So that is the east wind of the Holy Spirit.
We were all stunned. I stood up and shouted, "There's a God. I witnessed this miracle with my own eyes. It was not told or reported to me. I saw the hand of God send that missile into the sea."
And so as 577 made it kicks off on October 2, there was a phenomenon that happened in Jerusalem.
Japanese Imperial Army has no alternative but to marry Central Luzon, whose divine destiny is to echo the heartbeat of God to the nation.
Kamusta ka, Pampanga?
On June 15, 1991, Mount Pinatubay Rapto.
The greatest tragedy has become the greatest blessing because of the mighty hand of God.
It was a divine providence because if not, Pampanga would be buried in the heart. The pyroclastic deposit it emitted were carried by Typhoon Titi as far as Myanmar. But when Angeles City was dedicated to God, we have beheld the mighty name of God in that city.
The first city that was supposed to be buried in the heart, when dedicated to God, may inilagay pong malaking bato na humarang dun po sa lagusan ng lahar sa Angeles City, which is spelled Angeles City.
The second miracle of God.
And the next year po, as we dedicate Taunday,
and this became the central part of
our when Borac was dedicated to God, ang ginawa po ng Panginoon, ginawa po niya ito na lahat ng lahat dumali doon, and it has become the mining part of Pampanga.
But God caused the super typhoon to divert.
And in 1999, the Lord declares, now is the time to dedicate every city and province of your nation to the one true God.
Economic rebounding transpired. Again, Isaiah 61 was fulfilled.
And after 7 years, the Lord
transferred to the Filipino military.
Divinely intervened. And Pampanga were able to arose from ashes because of the mighty move of God. And now in our time, kung makikita po ninyo, wala na po mga malalakas na bagyo na dumarating sa ating bansa. This is the mighty hand of God. Amen. The Lord declares, in 2012, you have to stand again and echo national prayer of repentance. And during that time, ay dumating po ang malakas na lindol sa Davao, sa Sarangani, ay the first habagat na naghit sa ating bansa. But miraculously, when we dedicate the land for the glory of God, sabay-sabay po silang huminto. This is the mighty move of God. Hallelujah! Whenever the people of God repent and humble himself and exalt the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, the mighty hand of God moved to save the Philippines. And in 2012,
sa kanyang mukha na mamana sa ang ilang bahagi ng kanyang katap.
Pipili sa amin naman. Again, spiritual. Kaya nga, dalawang beses, dalawang gabi na kami matulog sa spiritual. Nakakatulog siya. Hindi pwede siya makakatulog.
Sa bayan ng diocese naman, nakilala namin ang binatiyong si Joseph. Apat na buwan pa lamang ang kanyang sugat. Pero sa bilis ng pagkalat ito sa kanyang katawan, hilap na siya makatayo.
Mama na parang officials ay balot sila ng parangba dahil nga sa pinapakita ang lakas nitong bagyong Ruby. Pero makalipas ang ilang oras, tila nagkaroon ng milagro while dininig yung panalangin ng maraming Pilipino ng nasa itaas. Mga siyentipiko man, tila naniniwala sa pag-aadya na may kapal sa pagbaba ng lakas ng bagyong Ruby.
At hindi lamang po sa bagyong Ruby, every time the nation faces catastrophe, the intercessors pray and seek the mercy of God. And now, all the typhoon and the cyclone that was strong enough na halos sumakop sa Pangluson,
¡Sora!
receive us as your one new man in Christ, Yeshua. And everybody say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And you know, my dear brethren, one of the Jewish traditions